I'm super pumped because today we're learning how to find, edit, and speed ramp slow motion video footage in your next DaVinci Resolve project. And to kick it off, did you know that you can save a lot of time by copying and pasting speed attributes? As usual, I have this video broken down into four simple chapters to make the learning process easier. And before we get any further, let's use our high school algebra cheat sheet to review maximum slowness. Is that even a word? That we can drop our clips down into for like a 24 FPS timeline without needing the crazy optical flow processing, which never turns out great anyways. Or maybe you can just screen grab this graphic here and we'll say we did. Now that we know what our limitations are without losing quality or using optical flow, let's dive in. So one of the problems when you're editing mixed frame rate or slow motion footage is you never know what the frame rate is once it's down on the timeline without looking at the clip attributes. And we're going to solve that today with using clip colors. And to get everyone on the same page, we're going to look at our project settings. We are taking a look at a 23976 timeline. So that's what our editing is going to be done at. And we're looking at thumb view and we need to see more information. So we're going to click list view right over here. And we need to sort by frames per second and clip color. Both headers are not here, so we're going to right click under clip name. We're going to choose FPS and clip color. And now that those are available, we can click on the top of FPS, which is our frames per second, and sort by those. And so what we're going to be doing is associating every one of the same frame rate to a very specific color. It's a color you're going to memorize. It's hopefully a color that you'll be able to pick up quickly so you can recognize what the frame rate is on the timeline once it's down there. So from Avid, this is something I learned, 23976 is always going to be green. So I set those to green. I'm going to choose my 2997 or my 30 FPS clips, change those to navy. Those will be blue. My 60 FPS clips are going to be purple. So I'll go up here and choose purple for those. And then finally, my special little 120 frames per second super duper slow-mo clips are going to be set to yellow. So now I know if I see a yellow clip on the timeline, it's 120 FPS, which means I know in just in my head that it can be slowed down to 20%. Or you could use this cheat sheet and take a look at how slow can I actually make that clip. So that's my first tip here is sort by clip color. And then your life is going to be so much easier because you know how slow you can make the clip when it's on your timeline. So we've got all our footage organized by frame rate and clip color. If we select all, Command A, and then F10 to overwrite those onto our timeline, we can see down here, it's awesome. We can see green's 24, we got blue 30, 60 is the purple, and then we've got 120 frames per second yellow. Now, the thing that happens when you put them onto your timeline is Resolve is gonna throw away the frames from the 120p clips here so that it plays it in real time. It's gonna assume that you don't want to see everything, every frame you shot, and it's going to assume you want to see real time. So the way we're going to slow this down, we're going to select it, and this is sort of new in Resolve. Over here, if we choose Inspector, you can open this up more if you click this little button, and there's a Speed Change tab here right now. And we know because it's 120 frames per second, we can slow it down to 20% speed. So under Speed Percentage, we can choose 20, right? And if you want to make sure that you have ripple sequence turned on, if you want to make sure your in and out point remain consistent on the clip. So now that we have 20 selected, we hit enter. And just like that, boom, zoom out a little bit. We can see every single frame from that in and out point that we had marked right there on the timeline, which is super handy. The little tab over here has a couple other good shortcuts. If you want to play it backwards, you can click this guy. And that just plays the clip in reverse, okay? So that's really helpful. And then finally, if let's say that's the key moment, that's where we want to freeze things at and lock in time. There's a little freeze icon here and that creates a freeze frame at that moment. So you can see it just locked everything right on in. It's like, oh, hold up. We need to take a timeout, something like that. So that's really helpful. The other things that are on this little tab here that you want to pay attention to are there's a ripple sequence, there's a pitch correction. So this is with audio. It's going to try to not make Mickey Mouse voices, but the ripple sequence one's actually pretty important. So I want to show you that one here on the clip before it. So let's say we don't want this clip to make the timeline longer or shorter. We would select it. You can make sure you turn the ripple sequence off. And then turn it to 20% and hit enter. And what this is going to do, it's still going to slow the clip down to see every frame, but it's going to ignore the out point. So you can see the timeline did not get longer, but we did in fact slow the clip down. So that is playing every single frame in slow motion on that roller coaster. Great roller coaster, by the way. That's at Universal. That's like a Hogwarts or whatever. So anyways, that is the speed change inspector method of slowing clips down here in DaVinci Resolve 17. This next tip to change clip speed is gonna go by so fast you might miss it. So I've got a time lapse here of the PCH I shot in Santa Monica, and it's 4 seconds long. Maybe I don't have that long in my video to show it, or maybe I wanna give it more energy. Well, we know it's 24 FPS because it's green, so we probably don't wanna slow it down. So what I'm gonna do is speed it up. So I select the clip by dragging the mouse and I right click. You can say change clip speed right here. And within this window, we can say, hey, let's make this clip 400% instead of 100%. So it's gonna go faster. It's gonna go 4 times faster. We're gonna choose a ripple sequence, which is gonna make the whole timeline shorter, but it's gonna keep the in and out points that are marked on the clip itself. We'll hit change, and you can see, boom, much faster clip. You can use the exact same technique if we jump over to a slow motion clip. So here's one with my buddy Paul out in the snow. It's dropping frames right now because it's trying to maintain that 100% timing of the 24p timeline. But we know it's purple, so it's 60 frames per second is what we shot, and we can slow it down to 40% speed. So we'll select it with our mouse, we'll right click and say change clip speed. And now we can change this. We double click in there and say 40 with our mouse again. And we're gonna also choose ripple sequence, which makes the timeline longer in this case. So it's the other direction. And just hit change, and now you can see everything in buttery smooth slow motion playing back right up there. Snow in slow motion just looks super cool in my opinion. But also, just so you know, if you select this and you say change clip speed, you have the same controls that you did over in the inspector under the speed change section here. So you have ripple sequence, reverse speed, freeze frame, all that sort of stuff. It's basically the same thing. It's just a different way of doing it. So if you don't want to open the inspector, you can always right click and say change clip speed. Next up, let's look at the retime controls here to do variable speed changes and speed ramps. So select a clip, right click it, and there is retime controls right there. It's command R. So command R on and off to access that. And a couple of things you want to set up, make sure you have here turned on. We're going to go to trim mode, which is this button here. This is gonna make sure we don't have any gaps in our timeline as we're making the changes and we're not overwriting the clips next to us. And then finally, if you go to keyboard customization and type in retime, there's a new option here called retime curve, and you can set this to whatever you want. It's not set by default, but I set mine to command shift R, and this gives you access to the little graph, little chart thing that lets you put like Bezier curves on things after you put stuff down and you want to refine it later, a little more advanced. But command shift R on and off for that, that's a super good one. And then actually this paper is shot is out of order from this keyboard. We want the keyboard to happen before that. So if I hit my selection arrow, I select this key and I use command shift, greater than and less than brackets. It's the ones next to M key on the keyboard, the period and the comma keys. Command shift to the left side moves that clip over there to the left and right. You can sort of see how that works. Really fast way of moving and swapping clips on the timeline. So now we have with that command shift comma or period, lesser than or greater than brackets, they're in the right order. Okay, so now we can do some speed changes. Let's use our command R to open up our speed change controls. We're gonna use option scroll to go in on that clip, and we're gonna find a point that we want to change the speed. Why don't we do it right as the finger's starting to come down? We'll do it right there. There's a little drop down here, and we're gonna say add speed point, okay? So add speed point is basically a keyframe that's gonna change on that position. And a couple of things we can do with this, let's say at the beginning, we want this to be playing even faster than 100%. Well, let's make this to change speed to 200%. It's a little shortcut preset that's built in there. Now you can't change these, I wish you could, but that has just made the left side faster. Okay, and then this other side, we know this is a 60 FPS clip from the beginning of the video where we changed the color to purple. And so we can change this a lot slower than it currently is. And before I do that, I wanna point out, we're not in trim mode, so let's go back to trim mode. This is gonna ripple the timeline for us. And we're gonna choose change speed to 50%. And so that you can see that pushed everything else back out on the timeline. And so it's not 40%, which is what we could do, but it's not creating frames on its own. So it's still pretty dang smooth if you check that out, right? So that's really helpful. The way this little speed point thing works, there's a top and a bottom. They both have different controls. The one on the top is gonna control the speed percentage of the left section or portion of your clip. And the bottom is gonna control what frame the change is gonna happen on. So if you take the left, the top section here, we're gonna actually move this to the left. It's gonna increase the speed of this left side. So you can see there, it went up to 367%. And then we're still at that 50% on the right side. So it's everything to the left. I'm gonna hit undo there, and then what if we wanted to, the moment of the speed change to happen later, you take the bottom of it, and then this actually changes like the location of the speed change. So our speeds are not changing. It's still 200%, it's still 50% on that side. It's just the location of when that moment happened is a little bit later. But I actually wanted it to be right as the key comes down, so I'll just move that over there. And that, in a nutshell, is kind of how the little speed ramp tool works right within here. But guess what? There's more. Of course, there's more, right? So if we hit that Command Shift R that we had talked about before, we'd set up to enable the retime, frame, and speed controls. We have a little bit more options. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more with options, scroll on the wheel here, and if we take a look here at this little drop down, we can choose retime speed, okay, and undo retime frame. And this gives us a little bit of a graph. And if we move in even a little bit further, we'll be able to see what's happening. So you can see there is a keyframe moment that's happening right here. If you select that and then you choose this guy right here, this changes it to a Bezier handle, and it just smooths things out. It makes things a little bit more buttery. So it's going from 200% to 50% in a much smoother fashion. So just a little way to finesse things a little bit. Not totally necessary. I've done a lot of, you know, worked on car commercials, food commercials and stuff where we just still use hard cuts. But this is a really fancy way of adjusting that right there. And if you want to go back to sort of the hard change, you can click that button right there. One other tip that I want to point out is you can actually extend this longer. Let's say we want this clip here instead of to be 50%. Let's see what it looks like at 25%. So we're actually going to be making up frames at this point. And to do that, we need to change some things so that we don't get this little jitter, okay? Go up to Inspector, you choose Retime Process, and under here, you have three options. These are from easiest to hardest. And if we choose Optical Flow, that's the hardest. It's going to be the most taxing on the computer, but it's going to give us the best results if we change motion estimation. So by default, it's going to choose this standard faster motion, which you can always take a look and see how it looks. Usually you get some weird artifacts. That wasn't actually terrible. But what I suggest is almost always choosing Enhanced Better, which is going to take a second to render for sure. But that's going to give you great results. It's basically an order of low quality to high quality. There's speed warp at the bottom. I almost never use that. It just takes forever. But if you choose Enhanced Better for motion estimation, that's a good way of getting pretty good results. Now you can see it's just dropping frames all over the place. And that's going to point me to one of my final tips here in the video, and that is render in place. So render in place is going to let us render this sucker out. So new to Resolve 17, you can render in place this clip. You're going to right click on it, and it's just right up there at the top, say render in place. You can choose your quality settings and all that right there. I'm going to just choose what's preset, say render. It's going to ask me where do I want this rendered file to live, and we'll just call this tutorial on the desktop. We'll say open, and it starts cooking that media out for us. And so it's basically, it's creating its own, it's not a cache, it's like an actual media file so that we can play this back and see it super duper smooth, right? So really cool thing, render in place right here in Resolve. It just swaps it out for us on the fly. Quick, I'm calling a timeout to welcome you if you're new here to the channel. My name's Chadwick, this is Creative Video Tips. It's all about helping you create videos that make a difference and stand out. If that's something you're into and you haven't already done so, click subscribe right down below right now so you don't miss out on the new tip next week. And with that out of the way, I've got a great bonus tip that I want to share with you about why you might not want to actually be using clip attributes to slow down your video footage. Now that you know all these techniques to use the timeline, I want to caution you to never really use the clip attributes to change your frame rate of a clip. So, you know, if you change this right here, you could change this to 23976 and it conforms the clip that used to be 60 and now it'll play that back in slow motion. So that, you know, that was obviously, that was much faster in real time. The reason I would suggest you not use clip attributes is if you're doing any sort of XML, AAF, EDL translations between editing systems, it's not gonna match up if both systems have not conformed them correctly on the source of the clip, which is almost never the case. So you'll be sending the source clips to someone and they'll be whatever their native frame rate was, which for this one, it was 59.94. That's how the other editing system needs to see them. So please, you're going to avoid so many headaches if you do not use clip attributes to conform your video frame rate here in Resolve, or even in Adobe Premiere has a way to do that that I know a lot of people use, rather than using the speed controls that are down there on the timeline. And the final bit of advice I have for you right now is to hit the like button. That way other people can find this video too if you found it helpful. And then keep learning DaVinci Resolve with the playlist I have coming up right now, and I'll see you in that next video.